In talking about ductal carcinoma in situ, DCIS, there are various things that go into the description of DCIS. The number one thing that we talk about is the grade of the in situ breast cancer. We actually have a grading system also for invasive breast cancers, but I'm going to focus right now on the grading system for in situ breast cancer. There are three grades: high grade, intermediate grade, and low grade. The three separate grades then are related to the biology of the in situ breast cancer. Low grade in situ breast cancer can develop over years, very similar to low grade cancer of the prostate in men, can be there for years. Remember, we often cannot diagnose in situ breast cancer unless there's an associated A, mass, or B, microcalcifications. The natural history of low-grade, truly low-grade in situ breast cancer is being actively debated now. There are some who feel that maybe we don't even need to treat low-grade DCIS, but more to be revealed on that subject later. Intermediate grade DCIS is the next step up. The turnover rate, the growth, the size is typically a little more aggressive than the low grade. I think there's consensus that all intermediate grade DCIS needs to be appropriately treated. Typical treatment is lumpectomy, often with radiation therapy, and or mastectomy. As we get into the whole issue about radiation therapy and in situ breast cancer, I've already done a video here at Breast Cancer Answers about the role now of the Oncotype DX analysis in determining and helping us determine things about the biology of the in situ breast cancer, what the chances are of the in situ breast cancer reoccurring, and therefore extrapolating that to the need for radiation therapy. Let me finish up then by talking about high-grade DCIS. And high-grade DCIS can be quite aggressive. Is if it gets very, very large, it's often associated with areas of invasive breast cancer. And the same is true, by the way, of intermediate-grade DCIS, that if there's a large area of intermediate-grade DCIS, there can also be associated small areas of invasive cancer. But high-grade DCIS tends to be a horse of a different color here. And what we have found and what I have found in my experience is that breast MRI can be very helpful in defining the extent of the high-grade DCIS to help us make decisions about lumpectomy with radiation therapy versus mastectomy. The high-grade DCIS can grow larger than the area of associated microcalcifications. I've recently also had a patient with extremely high-grade DCIS where there are malignant-appearing microcalcifications all over the breast. And this is an entity that's been particularly talked about by the world-famous breast radiologist, Dr. Laszlo Tabar. And Dr. Tabar feels that this really extensive high-grade DCIS should be thought of as invasive breast cancer and treated accordingly. Now, everything that we talk about when it comes to in situ breast cancer, there are a multitude of factors that go into treatment decisions, the need for radiation therapy, being on the lookout for invasive cancer associated with it, and therefore we need to be testing the sentinel lymph nodes. So again, my plea is always, work with a multidisciplinary team, work with a group of people and professionals who know how to sort these issues out to give you the very best advice about your in situ breast cancer. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.